Hello guys, this is me, Dr. Kashan Kasid. Today we are here to discuss another topic. But before that, I'm very thankful to you guys that you shared my video, you subscribed my channel, and today we are here just near the subscription, that is YouTube monetization program. So keep sharing, keep liking, and do subscribe also. So without wasting time, coming to the topic of the today, that is metabolic defect of the red blood cell. This is the another cause of inherited hemolytic anemia. We have classified anemia into five types, in which we have discussed the inherited hemolytic anemia, the causes of which were: number one, membrane defect, that is the hereditary spherocytosis. The second one was Hb abnormality, in which we have discussed the sickle cell syndrome and alpha and beta thalassemia. So today we are here with another, that is the metabolic defect of the red cell membrane, which is leading to inherited hemolytic anemia. So the mature red cell has no nucleus, mitochondria or ribosome, we know that. Therefore, they are unable to synthesize energy as well as proteins through these organelles. So the red cell need energy in the form of ATP for its flexibility and also for its biconcave shape. So this energy is actually coming from two pathways. Number one here is the glycolytic pathway, the second one is HMP pathway. The first one, that is the glycolytic pathway, here is converting actually the glucose into glucose 6 phosphate through this enzyme, that is hexokinase. And in this step, ATP is actually converted into ADP. This ATP is converted into ADP. The second step here is the glucose 6 phosphate, which is converted into PEP, that is phosphoenol pyruvate, and this is the multiple enzymatic step, and there will be production of ADP as well here. The ADP generation will occur in this second step as well. The third step here is the phosphoenol pyruvate, which is converted into pyruvate through enzyme, that is pyruvate kinase, and this is very important enzyme in this reaction, because this enzyme deficiency will result in the decreased production of ATP, and we need ATP for the red cell membrane integrity, flexibility, and for its biconcave shape. So once there is the pyruvate kinase deficiency, or there is a decreased level of pyruvate kinase enzyme, this will result in the decreased production of ATP, and this will eventually will result in the rigidity of the cell, and the red cell membrane become rigid and they will lyse, and this will lead into the condition we called it anemia. The second pathway required for the production of energy is HMP pathway, that is hexose monophosphate pathway. The process, that is first one, is the same, glucose is converted into glucose 6 phosphate. From the second step, glucose 6 phosphate is converted into 6 phosphoglycerate by the enzyme, that is we called it glucose 6 phosphate dehydrogenase. So this reaction is very important, because it is producing the NADPH, which is required for the conversion of this oxidized glutathione into reduced glutathione. This element, reduced glutathione, is very important because it is protecting normally the red cell membrane. This is the red cell membrane. Normally this is at continuously at a stress, and reduced glutathione is actually protecting this red cell membrane. So once there is a deficiency of this enzyme, that is G6PD, there will be also decreased level, that is not adequate level of this element, that is reduced glutathione production, and this will lead into the hemoglobin precipitation into the red cell membrane, and this we called it the Hans bodies. We call these as Hans bodies, and this will result in the lysis of the RBCs, and this lysis or destruction of the RBC will result in the anemia, that can also be acute hemolytic anemia, and it can also be a chronic hemolytic anemia, or there can be also other clinical features. So these two enzymes, that is G6PD and pyruvate kinase, are very important for the production of energy as well as for the maintenance of biconcave shape and flexibility of the red cell membrane. We have discussed earlier the two pathways and the two enzymes, that pyruvate kinase and G6PD. that is the deficiency of both these two enzymes, how these are leading to the hemolysis of RBCs. Now here we are with the clinical features, or there can also be a clinical syndrome. Clinical feature involve the acute hemolysis, that is the hemolysis of RBCs, which are leading to acute hemolytic anemia, and they can also develop the chronic hemolytic anemia when there is a severe enzyme deficiencies. Third one here is the neonatal jaundice. The infant born with the glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency will develop the neonatal jaundice. There are certain drugs which are inducing the hemolysis, that is the drugs like aspirin and anti-malarial drugs and certain analgesics as well. So these are the clinical features of these patients. Coming to its management, management involves the first one, that is any offending drug should be stopped. That is these drugs we have discussed, that aspirin, anti-malarial drugs or the other drugs which are leading to hemolysis, they should be stopped. The infection should be treated first, and there should be blood transfusion, which can be life-saving process. And management are important for the patients who are dealing with these conditions. So today we are done with the metabolic defects of the red blood cells, which are leading to the anemia, and as well as we are also done with the inherited hemolytic anemia. Now we will discuss in the next videos another type of the anemia. Thank you guys, keep sharing and keep supporting.